Hey guys, Kieran here with ExploreMinate. Welcome to another Let's Showcase for Shallow Space. This is version 8.1, so unfortunately I wasn't able to get a video out for 8.0. So we're going to be covering a lot of stuff in this video. First off, you know, they always like showcasing their new beauty. This is the Cambridge Battleship. But now you might be thinking to yourself, there already was a Cambridge Battleship. Well, there was. Well, this is version 2.0. So it looks a lot slicker. It's a little tougher and stuff, as we'll check out. But there's also another beauty that came out that we're going to show off right now. Well, let's stick with... Here we go. Vindicator. This is what I was talking about. So this guy looks kind of like... He looks different, which I appreciate. This is a battleship. It is basically a missile battleship. So before you had the Blackbirds, right? Some ammo. So now you've got a battleship. It's got two more bays for ammo, which is great. I think the missiles come out of there. It looks cool. It looks very different, which I like. But you know, it's great to see they continue to pump out like great looking 3D models of these ships. Obviously customizable like normal. And this guy's fun to use. I'll go into this more later. I don't think I'm using missile ships accurately. Not accurately. Correctly, because I like typically lose when I have a lot of them. But it doesn't defeat the fact that it's really fun to like volley with some missiles and just watch the enemy battleship like die in a volley or two. Pretty satisfying. So this is the old Cambridge battleship. This is the new Cambridge ship. Load in. Here we go. Yeah. Looks better, I think. Just a little slicker. It's got more guns, another support module spot. It costs, 350 more points, I think, and it's got a little bit more meat to it. So that's nice to have that superior ship in that way. They also have, like, freighters. And if you go down here, you've got a smaller freighter and a general support unit. Those are basically just placeholders, from what I can tell. Right now, they don't really... I guess I haven't experimented with the whole fleet of those guys. You can't put guns on them or anything, so... wouldn't do much good. But if you read on the website for Shallow Space, they talk about how there'll be some base management, some resource collection, stuff like that when the game finally launches. And, of course, it's still in alpha right now. So that stuff's just kind of placeholders, but... They look pretty cool for freighters. I mean, as cool as a freighter can look. That's not to knock them or anything, but, well done models. It'll be interesting to see what role they play, if these are going to be more just guys you protect, and then, like, maybe the general support unit, if these will be refilling missiles, that would be great, because you run out of missiles pretty quick right now. But, yeah, I haven't done anything with them, because let's put a bunch of shields on them. They just die slower. I don't know. I'll leave it there. We do have some new modules, though. Which is kind of cool. So before, they added like the different shield hardeners and things. I still love that effect. Oh, just gotta click that. Look at that. Look at that. That's still beautiful. You got web fires. So you got three times: the passive omnidirectional web fire, the active omnidirectional web fire, and the active directed web fire. So these target the ship's engines, as you see in the tooltip down here. Bottom left corner for 30 seconds. It's going to interfere and slowing them down. So what I'm about to say, I'm kind of inferring some things from other games, but essentially a web fire, think like, you know, Star Wars Episode 4, right? Millennium Falcon getting pulled in with a tractor beam. It's a little different than that. It's going to slow down the Millennium Falcon so the Death Star can hit it. Would be more probably the route of what a web fire is. So pretty useful when you think about, especially these extra large guns. Let's look at put a few large rail guns. This guy's massive. Like, if you compare that to some of the smaller ships, like, that gun is comparable to them, okay? It can rotate 40 times a minute, which you think's pretty good, but essentially it can rotate once every second and a half. So the tracking, and again, this is just still me inferring from other games, isn't going to be as good, so you might miss some shots. And we know that you do miss shots in this game. They have that all programmed in, which is pretty cool, right? Not everything hits. That's pretty realistic, right? So web of fire is going to slow down a small target to make it easier for a big ship to hit. Also, if you look at the like the controls when you're playing, there's options that aren't activated yet, like to target engines or different systems within a spaceship to shut them down, which I think is a cool idea. Perhaps a web of fire will allow us to hit engines easier. You know, make some of those shots that normally, if this guy's flying by and you're just shooting at him, if you slow him down, it's going to be easier for those guns to track and hit right where you want them, as opposed to just hit this side of this wall, you know, right? So that's some inferring. I've practiced. I've played around with them a little bit. I equipped two different battleships with different web of fires. Don't really see the difference between them yet. I think as the tooltips are developed and the modules implemented a little bit more, that might become a little clearer. Active, though, you have to activate that on a ship. Active omnidirectional, you have to activate that. And then omnidirectional, I assume you get everyone in a vicinity. And then passive is probably just weaker, but does constantly slow enemy ships. So those are some cool modules to see. I continue to be very impressed with the depth of customization of these ships. You're not just rock, paper, scissoring with, like, lasers and kinetic and plasma or whatever, you know, like is common in many space games, which is fine. But you also have the different armor types, some of these support modules, shields, hardeners, now web of fire. So it's neat to see them just adding pieces to this puzzle with every iteration of the alpha. So that's pretty cool. I think that's it for now. I mean, the old Cambridge battleship's still there. I kind of hope they keep it, just like have the classic version, because they already have it made. Why get rid of it? Like, it doesn't look bad. It looks pretty cool, but the new Cambridge battleship definitely looks cooler. And again, let's not forget our friend the Vindicator. But yeah, so that's it for the hangar. Let's jump over to the simulation real quick. So same old, right? You can autofill. I don't know if you could do that before. Well, you can autofill now. Maybe you could before. it's kind of hard after doing these to remember. Did they just add this? Especially since I'm kind of doing two videos in one here. So my apologies if that is old. But that is a great feature. If you don't want to take the time to customize your ship, yeah, make a pretty legitimate fleet. Also, as you mouse over your guys, you can see what they have. Well, you're supposed to be able to. Oh, down here you can at least. All right, so you see right here it's changing. So you kind of have to know what those are, right? But there's not that many kinds of railgun, right? You should be able to tell if it's extra large or large, or if it's a Gatling gun. With a little play, you will know. And if that's too complicated at the beginning, or you just want to, like, mash stuff together, that's what we have the autofill button for. They also added some options. So the simulator can now simulate with our nice little red bubble friend, or you can go to space, which is pretty, which is this background. I prefer that. I mean, there's nothing wrong with this, but the other is just prettier. Speed multiplier, crank that up if you want. I usually just leave it 1 because you know you can change that in game, but some people might want to increase that. This is the doozy right here. This is the golden ticket. You can move multiplayer battles up to 3,000 multiplayer points. I don't know, what's that mean? MP, I call them multiplayer points. I don't know. Anyways, essentially you can like triple the size of what you're doing, sort of, in some instances. And then you can toggle off if it's mirrored or random, and then the number of enemy capital ships, which is kind of cool. So a lot more control over that, and a lot bigger battles. We'll show some off later on. Let's go back real quick. Boom. Go back to the menu. Okay, so the game paused, as you see. We've got some over here. Oh, there's a trading post. Sweet. Oh, and there is a jump gate. Oh, so they just, I guess assault isn't a thing, but they kind of snowballed that into this. Okay. Well, let's unpause it real quick. We're going to watch our fleets jump in. And so alerts you. You can focus on the enemy, but there we are. Excellent, right? Okay, so our wings are all out of range. We're still coming in. All right. Anyways, okay, so we got some enemies. Let me get my mini map going. Zoom it out. So they made a cool change where you have to, like, Oops. Let's get everyone to move over here. Because I bet there's going to be some bad guys this way. So before it was really hard, like, to navigate. Now if I'm holding right button now, and if I want to move somebody, you tap right button. So everyone converge to indicated point, please. Where are you going? Everyone's hopping right there, right? Oh, the game's paused. Moving. So you see everybody moving. It's getting crazy. Boom, boom. I want you to move up here as well. Yep. Let's go for it. And let's actually turn everybody on aggressive. I want them to just engage as soon as we hit. And we're going to do a short-range jump with everybody. Boom. That's all. I love that ability. That your ships can jump around. Okay. So we're up in here. Enemy wing spotted. Can we, like, destroy this thing? Wasn't actually able to try this out. So let's just go. Launch all wings. Get everyone out. And we're going to speed it up a little bit because we're kind of slow. So this is normal speed. We're going to move it up to 175 real quick. That's just going to allow us to... Let's get in on these guys. Follow behind everybody. Alright, are we engaging? So we've got some freighters coming by. Looks like some pirates maybe going to try to pick them off. Just a bunch of little ships, but let's... Ooh. Nice. Wonder if I can actually... Here, we'll just follow this little guy for a second. Yep. We got a fighter. Oh, that'll make you sick. I like how you can just, like, zoom in and follow these guys, though, because these battles get pretty cinematic. What are the actual objectives for this, though? This is completely different than... Sorry, I've tried this mode out in 8, but not 8.1, so... It's a problem here. Let's activate our special weapons. You gotta appreciate, though, kind of the scale this game's getting on, as well as how pretty it is. Look at the siege lasers just tearing into that. Well, that thing just blew up, whatever it was. And now we've got... So this is where Web of Fire would be useful. We've got all these little ships. It's going everywhere. Trying to take them out, but it's probably pretty hard for us to actually hit them. Come on, dude, attack. There we go. Well, let's look out. What are you doing objective? The command ship must survive the mission. Okay. Oops. I escaped one too many times there. Send these guys over to engage the railgun. The railgun platform. Can we do command? We don't have that. Alright. Well, sector scan at least. Let's see if we can't find any baddies somewhere. So one thing I wish they had was a little bit more interaction with the mini-map, but I'd be surprised if that's not added later on. And there's a lot of those little buggers, aren't there? They're just everywhere. Ooh, what do we got over here? Ooh, got some cruisers. Excellent. Oh, this railgun platform is getting rocked. Oh, there's some of that... I don't know if that has shields or if it has hardeners. You saw that it must have been shields because it's not showing up anymore. It was glowing blue. That was cool. I like those effects. You can see. Get up there. Come on. All right. Let's get everybody back together. So these are just... These must be NPCs. Anyway, so you see how there's going to be, like, multiple factions doing stuff. That's super specific. I'm sure they're like, oh, great. This guy's talking about factions doing stuff. It's very specific. This gives you a little taste, I think, of what the game will have. I'll just do a brawl in a separate video. So I'll leave it there. You get to see kind of the scale of things. I don't really have anything to add, but sure is a pretty game. Let's zoom into this guy real quick, our new Cambridge. Just cruising through there with his wingmen. Tearing into these guys. It's actually pretty nice. Check that out. Let's get down there. Let's get down there. Come on. Oh, he's gonna dive. This is cool. Whoop, let's stay on him. So does he have any fixed weapons? I know I said I was gonna go, but then I just got excited with this guy, so we're gonna stick with it for a second. At least till we blow up these pirates. But that's shallow space for you guys. I mean, look at that beautiful planet in the background. We're gonna take a screenshot right now. Sorry, I just had to. I don't know. If you like space battles, I just don't know how you can't be a little bit excited about this game. So, but there it is. Those are the updates. 8.1 came out pretty recently, so I expect 9. You know, we'll have to wait a little bit more for that. But that's what we have for now. And I'll do another video of me just brawling in simulation, where I know a little bit more what's going on. But thank you for watching. Please keep checking back for our coverage for Shallow Space. This is a game, as I always say, I'm very excited for to see as it continues to come forward through development. So check that out, and we'll catch you next time. Until then, thanks for watching, and see you then.